Greetings! Happy Wednesday! Well, welcome to my my empty office in Belle Isle, Florida. All right, so we're gonna do our usual thing tonight, and adjust that. That's good enough, right? And we've got some new songs. We're going to have some songs we've done before. We're going to do a little tutorial for a U2 song. I think I sent out a little teaser on that. So, and no guest tonight. But next week, I believe we will have a guest. So we'll do that when we can. It's not easy. Not easy convincing someone to sing in front of online, in front of people that they don't know and can't see. So I'm working on it. Anyway, so we're going to start with Stand By Me. Someone last week had sent a note saying, hey, can you tell us the strums? I mean, island strum works a lot. So I will show you a few things, like when we're doing something different than an island strum, and we're going to do a few of those tonight. Just so songs sound a little different. If you play every song always with the island strum, songs start to sound very similar. So we'll do a few of those things tonight. All right, so Stand By Me. So I'm going to do an fan strum. So a fan strum, we've talked about that before. and my sister, who lives in Colorado, is joining, which is fun. And my dad's out there too, figuring out how to do the comments, so we might see him shortly. So we are going to do a fan strum. Again, if you haven't done that, and I'll switch this to lyrics, don't worry. I just wanted to be bigger so you can see this part, and then I'll switch over. So the fan strum, you're basically, all right, that's probably good. I am doing my fingers so they're coming out like this, from my pinky forward to my pointer finger. And then I'm bringing that down on the string and doing that same motion. So I'm basically doing this, right? So I'm fanning that out across the strings. So I'm hitting the strings a total of 16 times, right? So if I have four fingers and four strings, I'm actually getting 16 strings. Just a little different sound, something to practice. So we've mentioned that before. When you're first doing that, it almost seems impossible. Like my fingers will never do that. They can go the other way, but they will. If you do that enough, they will do that. All right, so Stand By Me. We are gonna start with that, and I'm gonna switch over here to lyrics. And hey, look at that. My dad is online. Say hello. Say hello to my dad, folks. His name is Mike. He lives in Melbourne. And he joins every week. So, alright. He doesn't play the ukulele, but he loves singing. Alright, so here we go. Stand By Me. We're going to come in on a C. A 1. A 2. A 1, 2, 3, and...
If the sky that we look upon
temple and fall, or the mountain should crumble to the sea. I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by me. And darling, darling, stand by me, oh, stand by me, oh, stand by me. Darling, stand by me, oh, stand by me, oh, stand, stand by me, stand by me. Alright, we're going slow, we're starting slow, we're going to warm up our fingers a little bit. I believe we have done this one before. Really nice song. A couple things to point out. Chords, nothing unusual. I don't think so. So, nothing unusual. There is one part in this, just to be aware of, when you get to the later part of the verses, the last two lines, they're not full strums. So that, and then she asks me. So it's like this, it goes, and if she asks me, do I look alright? So it's just down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up on those last three chords in that line. Does that make sense? And if she asks me, and I say yes, you look wonderful. So that's it. Other than that, it's just a standard island strum. You could fan strum this, it would sound good. You could chuck this slowly, and that would sound pretty good. So that would sound pretty good too. So different options. All right. So a one, a two. A one, two, three, and. It's late in the evening. She's wondering what clothes to wear. Puts on her makeup and brushes her long blonde hair. And if she asks me, do I look alright? And I said, yes, you look wonderful tonight. Party, and everyone turns to see this beautiful lady that's walking around with me. And if she asks me, do you feel alright? And I said, yes, I feel wonderful. I feel wonderful because I see the love light in your eyes. And the wonder of it all is that you just don't realize how much I love you. Time to go home now, and I got an aching head, so car keys, and she helps me to bed. And then I tell her, as I turn out the light, I said, my darling, you were wonderful tonight. Oh, my darling, you were wonderful tonight. Hi. Hello, welcome, Gwen. That's nice of you to say hi to my dad. Okay. So we've done this before. We did this with a slow picking pattern, which is nice. Tonight we're gonna do it just a little faster with a more of a normal strum. Again, a fan strum would work nice with this. Softer, sweeter sounding, but I'm just going to do a regular island strum on this. Couple things to point out. So it looks like a lot of chords. So if you're looking at this and saying, "Hey, where's my three chord song? I want that." So C, A minor, F, G, G7, A7, D minor. So most of those you probably know. If you look at E minor is that stair step one. So let me switch over here to full screen. So if we look at the E minor is just that stair step, right? That is E minor. A B7, which is also in the song, and it goes into and out of an E minor. So a B7 is simply that same shape, just up. Just up one set of strings, so if you can see that, yep. So that's an E minor. Just move up towards your chin, and that's a B7. So, let's go back here. So that's what I'm talking about. If you look at the E minor, right? Stair step, if you look at the B7, they're really almost the exact same thing, just one string towards your chin. So, with that said, we will start. Let's just vamp on C for a minute. We're gonna go about that speed. Yeah? Okay. A one, a two, a one, two, three, and. Some things are meant to be. as I can. Hell, falling in love with you. Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Something simply means to play the chords. It's the words are there just so in your head you kind of get an idea of the timing and such of the chord progression. But it is just an intro, and sometimes you'll see them in an interlude instrumental portion in the middle of a song. But that's what that means. That is it. So, a little bit of love. We have never done this. This is a Jack Johnson song. If you don't know who Jack Johnson is, it's great music, real laid back, kind of Hawaiian-y, just very chill, very cool stuff. So, a little bit of love, and I want to talk about one part in here. Most of the chords, yep, C, A minor, great, G, F, right? We know these. And then you got this, oh, where did it go? The F7. So just take a look at that F7. That's not something that gets played a whole lot. And if I zoom in on that, go ahead and... So if you look at an F and an F7, obviously they're very close. And you're adding the 7th. And that is just your ring finger on the C string of the 3rd fret. So that's an F. An F7. So that is something to point out in that song. And is there anything to point out else? So the instrumental portion, like I mentioned, the green is just play along. And once you kind of know how the tune is, obviously the seeing the lyrics helps when you're doing that instrumental. Hello, Liz. Hello, Sue. All right, so this is a really nice song. I think you're going to like this. The scratch intro, and that's how the song starts, if you hear it, if you look it up on YouTube or whatever. So that's kind of how the song starts. It's a nice way to set the tempo of a song. Especially if you're playing with people, you can kind of tell them this is the tempo of the song. They can catch on because they're just hearing a scratch. But it's also a nice little percussive beginning to the song. So all you're doing is muting your strings and just lightly touching all 4 strings. What I'm doing here, again, this is just because it's easier for me. I'm putting my index finger on a C. And you're like, well, that's not how you play a C. Well, it's easy if you put your index finger on the C and just lightly touch the strings. Now the reason I do this is so when you come out of this, you can just lift these fingers and you're already at the C. You don't have to then try to find the C real fast. And that's the only time you play the C like that, right? Then you're back to your normal C throughout the song. But lift your fingers, right? So otherwise you'd have to be up here somewhere and then try to jump over to get the C. So, not something you have to do at all, but you might find it easier. All right. Here we go. Hopefully this is the right speed. So we're going to start with that island strum scratch four times. It is 7:29. All right. Hello, Liz. Mine three. Mine two. I got it. All right. Here we go. So CCR from John Fogerty. Again, this beginning. So let's look at chords. The E minor and E minor. The E minor seven. If you look at that, basically, it is a G shape with your ring finger lifted. So that's all you're doing there. And if you look at the song, we come from E minor 7. No, we don't in this. I thought we did. So you can play it like that. So if you're just playing a regular G and just use those same two fingers, often I thought the song did it, but I was incorrect. So there are a number of songs where you come into or out of the G from an E minor 7, and it's just easy to play the G shape and just lift the finger. So, all right. And that first part is normally where you hear that bass line. But we don't have a bass, so we won't hear that. Maybe I'll mouth that part. All right, a one, a two, a one, two, three, and... in there. So you're actually doing, I should have maybe mentioned that beforehand, but I will now. So if you're doing that, you're like, I want to know, and then here, have you ever seen the rain? So I'm just doing down, down, up there in that spot. And that's the only way you can really fit the chords to the lyrics. One other thing. And again, I think just something to be mindful of. So when you learn an island strum, you're like, yes, now I can play the ukulele. But if you play every song with a full island strum for every chord, every song starts to sound a little bit alike. And we did that in this song. But in this song, just to kind of differentiate your building into the chorus, right? Coming out of the verse, building into the chorus, you've got that C to C7, that shining down like water. That C7, if you switch up your strum there, and I think one that sounds good is just a simple down, up, down, up, down, up, instead of an island strum. So you're like, We'll start with when it's over. So, when it's over, so they say, it'll rain a sunny day. I know that now this part here, shining down like water, and here, I wanna know. So, it's just a little different sounding. And someone will say, oh, what? Something changed. That's kind of interesting. So, not something you happen to do, but it's really easy to do. You're just doing down and down and down and down on C7, and then straight back into normal island strum on F. So, hopefully that's something helpful. All right. Kiss the girl, then what next? Okay, then we have a little tutorial. All right, so kiss the girl. Again, we keep saying island strum. It just sounds different. The same strum can sound very different in a variety of songs. So this is a Disney tune from Little Mermaid, right, I believe? Easy chords. Let's just vamp on C. To say, but there's something about her, and you don't know why, but you're dying to try. You wanna kiss the girl, yes, you want her. Look at her, you know you do. Possible she wants you too. There's one way to ask her. It don't take a word, not a single. La 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 la, my oh my, look at the boy too shy, ain't gonna kiss the girl. Sha la 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 la, ain't that sad, ain't a shame too bad, he gonna miss the girl. We're gonna skip that instrumental. Now's your moment, floating in the blue lagoon. Boy, you better do it soon, no time will. Say a word, she don't say a word, and she won't say a word until you kiss the girl. Sha la 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 la, don't be scared, you got the mood prepared, go on and kiss the girl. Sha la 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 la, don't stop now, don't try to hide it now, you want to kiss the girl. Let me have the lyrics catch up. Sha la 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 la, float along and listen to the song. The song said, kiss the girl. Sha la 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 la, music play. Ah, goodness. Play, yeah, do what the music play. You got to kiss the girl. You got to kiss the girl. You got to kiss the girl. Sorry about that scrolling. That's not going to be good if you watch this back. You don't want to play along with that. All right. So what I was saying before. So to try to make your strum sound a little different. We could do this song. Most of you probably know this. We could do this just to a normal island strum, right? I have climbed the highest mountains. I have run through the fields only to be with you, right? We could do that. And we could do that the whole way through, and that'd be fine. But if you want to just do something to make it sound a little different, so it looks like there's a lot of chords. There's really three chords to the song with three accentuating chords. So if you look at the C, and then up top, if we look at a C, and if we look at a C sus 4, right? So just play a C, normal way to play a C, and then use your pointer finger to hold that spot, that first fret on the E string. That's C4. Right? So that's an easy one. We'll cover F. And if you look at F and D minor, if you look at those next two, again, hold the F shape, and then you're going to accentuate with the D minor. We'll show you where in just a minute. The last last one is G, and G sus 2. So if you hold down the G, and then lift up your middle finger, keep the rest of the shape in place. So make a G. Right? So that's a G sus 2, G sustained 2. So what we want to do here, if you look at this, this is where it gets interesting. So we're going to spend a few minutes on this. All right, so if you see where it says C with the asterisk, so that C with the asterisk is in the song too. So if you look down below where it says intro, I have climbed C with the asterisk. So you're going to do that strum in that spot, and then a regular C on mountain, if that makes sense. So the way that works is if you look at down, so this is an island strum. So if you look at that C asterisk, so we're looking at this one right in the middle here. It's down, down, up, up, down, up, right? We know that's an island strum. But on the third down, just for a split second, we are going to drop our finger onto that spot that makes it a C sus 4. So does that make sense? We want to do this. So I'm doing down, down, up, up, down, up, just like a regular island strum. And then I'm throwing down my finger just on that down. And then as soon as that down's done, I release it and do my up. So I know it seems a little much, but it'll be something good to practice. So I'm going to switch real quick over to this so you can kind of see what I'm doing. So I'm holding the C, right? Holding the C. Right? So you see how that's doing that? Just on that down. And it's like anything, muscle memory. So practice that a little bit. The next one is the F. And we're going to do pretty much the exact same thing. We are going to do a down, down, up, up, down, up. The only difference is we're going to drop our ring finger to make it a, what was that? The F sus 2? F sus 4. Yep. No, sorry. We're going to make it a D minor. It says so right there. Oh, come on, Greg. All right, so we're going to accentuate with the D minor, so it'll sound like this. To this, same thing. I'm making an F. I'm making an F. What's the best way to show you? Maybe there. So then I'm dropping my finger to the D minor. Seems like a lot, but it really will be good stuff to practice. The last one is the G and the G sus 2. On this one, it's still an island strum, but we hold down that G sus 2 on the ups, on both ups. You can see that. And then the last up. So it's a little trickier. So it's like... That's what we're going for. So, it's best to practice slow, but we'll move on. If you just want to do an island strum through this whole thing, it'll work just fine. The other thing we're going to do, because we could just stop there and it would sound good and add those things, so it would sound like this. But we're going to go a little crazy here. We're going to add in a chuck. And it really starts to make... I just want to sort of show how different the Islands drum can sound from what we started with. So if you start with a chuck, you do... Strum will fit in. If you want to try those things, you certainly can. Hello, Tracy Jane. Greetings. Thanks for joining. All right. So we're just going to start. And you can do the things you're comfortable doing. But I would practice because you can throw those things in a lot of different songs. Anytime, maybe not anytime, but a lot of times instead of just playing a C over and over, you can just drop that down. Just mixes it up a little bit. All right. Are you ready? We'll start right now. With a fan strum works really well. Okay, so just a regular islands drum works.
Are you ready?
Something's not right here. You can do it. Something is not right. I am extremely out of key. So sorry to put you through that. Hold on, let me get into key here. You can dance. You can dance. Every dance with the... That sounds more like it. All right, here we go. I've said it before. You get what you pay for. All right, one, a two. A one, two, three, and... You can dance, every dance with the guy who give you the eye and let him hold you tight. You can smile, every smile for the man who held your hand in the pale moonlight. But don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, say the last dance for me. Oh, I know that the music's fine, like sparkling wine, go and have your fun. Laugh and sing, but while we're apart, don't give your heart to anyone. But don't forget who's taking you home, and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, say the last dance for me. Baby, don't you know I love you so? Can you feel it when we touch? I will never ever let you go. I love you oh so much. You can dance, go and carry on till the night is gone and it's time to go. Don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, say the last dance for me. And you know, aye. But don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, the last dance for me. Say the last dance for me. Say the last dance for me. Sorry about that. Oh, what do we have left? Let me look real quick. Why can we... Oh, wow. We might not do all our songs. We'll see. We shall see. Wagon wheel. I think we know this. No unusual chord. So we will just get started.
Run from the
and I was born to be a fiddler and an old-time string band. My baby plays the guitar, I play the banjo now. Oh, the North Country winters keep forgetting me now. I lost my money playing poker, so I had to retire. But I ain't turning back, living that old life no more. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. Walking to the south, out of Roanoke, I caught a trucker out of Philly, had a nice long toque. But he's heading west from the Cumberland Gap to Johnson City, Tennessee. And I gotta get a move on, fit for the sun. Hear my baby call my name, and I know that she's the only one. And if I die in Raleigh, at least I will die free. Oh, rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like a wind in the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. Hey, mama, rock me. Skip over this one because I want to do this one. So C sharp minor. So it's a nice song. You probably recognize the song. Many of you do. Fairly easy chords, right? When you look at that, until you look at the C sharp minor. And just for a moment, try to play that C sharp minor. However you think you should. I mean, I think you would use your, you know, your pointer and your middle finger. Or you could maybe bar that. But for me, getting my pinky over to the fourth fret on the A string, really hard for me to do. Especially if I'm moving from a chord into that, you know, in a song fairly quickly. So I think that's kind of difficult to play. So I want to show you a couple things. I've mentioned this site before. So there's a site called Uke Buddy, which is a really good resource, especially if you want to learn different versions of the same chord. So if you look at this, I'm on the part of the site where I can choose a chord namer. I'm in chords. So, and I've selected C sharp, if you see that, and also minor. And it's showing me that that's the C sharp minor. That's the one we just looked at in the on song chord. But if you look here, we also see this is number 1 of 11. That means on the ukulele, on the fretboard, there are 11 ways to play a C sharp minor. So we're going to look at the second way to play it. So if you look at that, that's still a C sharp minor. And what I was tinkering with, because I'm really not sure how much I had played a C sharp minor before. And I never used my thumb to play a chord. I've seen people do that and I'm like, that's strange. But when I was tinkering with this chord today, I was tinkering with that. So if I hold my my middle two fingers, my middle finger and my ring finger, and hold those that C and E in this chord, you know, the two on your fourth fret, and bring my thumb over the top of the ukulele, I know that seems bizarre, and you might have no problem at all doing this, but I just want to show you what I'm How I'm attempting. So I'm putting this and this here, right? So I'm playing that chord like that. Oh, that's probably a good view there, right? Simple. But what I'm doing here is I'm bringing my thumb over the top just enough to hold down that G string. And it actually works fairly well. So that might be terrible for you because I struggled with that a little bit. I wanted to show you what I did. So that's how I'm going to play that. Because in one part of the song, you play this two times, the C sharp minor. So anyway, very useful website, UkeBuddy. Again, I mentioned it before. And I can scroll through and I can see all the ways I can play a C sharp minor or any other chord. So it's kind of handy to do that. All right, so let's go back. Hopefully technology is good to us. And then here's the song. All right, so let's, real quick, before we get into it, we're going to go to the bridge here. And if you look at the second line of the bridge, that looks straight ahead, there's nothing but blue sky. So you start with an A, and then you go into that C sharp minor. So it's a bear, but... So it's tricky. It's one of those things, just takes a little practice, especially the C sharp minor. So give it a try. We are going to go through that. If you're really struggling, you could probably just cheat. I don't think anyone's really gonna know, but you could probably just play a C there. Anyhow, let's go to the top here. Alright, a one, a two, a one, two, three, and. I can see clearly now the rain is gone. I can see all obstacles in my way. Gone are the dark clouds that made me blind. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. Yes, I can make it now, the pain is gone. All of the bad feelings have disappeared. Here is the rainbow I've been praying for. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. It's gonna be, oh wait, here we go, in the bridge. Look all around, it's nothing but blue. Look straight ahead, there's nothing but blue sky. I can see clearly now the rain is gone. I can see all obstacles in my way. Yeah, that rainbow I've been praying for. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. All right, so practice your C sharp minor. Okay, what else do we got here? I melt with you. It is 5 after. Let's take a quick look here. But we're going, let's do Chicken Fried and then Three Little Birds. So two more songs and we'll close out. We'll do Melt With You another time. All right. So we've done this one before. Zac Brown song. Ready? A one, a two, a one, two, three, and... was killed and I didn't know. Very funny. Alright, so last song of the night is our usual last song of the night. So just for kicks, can someone put a comment in the little comment section? Because we are... Oh, okay, you're still on. Thank you. Hello, Rita. Thank you. All right, so Three Little Birds, You know the chords, and as usual, I'm going to chuck this one. Let's just vamp on C. Sorry about that. Internet is a funny thing. It's good and horrible at the same time. So I really did hope you had a good time. When we're doing this, goodbye to my sister. You bet, Bobby. When we're doing this, if you do have songs, these songs are not perfect. Because it's not easy to, you know, every week to come up with new stuff. But I try to, you know, try to make it respectable and hopefully useful for you. And hope to see you again next time. Spread the word. We are going to keep these up after isolation and COVID and coronavirus. We're going to keep this up after all those things are long past us. So hopefully we'll, you know, we'll grow this and be able to, you know, have fun together going forward. So take care of yourself, please. And take care of each other. A lot of people need it. And we will see you next time. Bye, y'all. Be good. Take care.